Bonjour à toutes et bonjour à tous.
Nous sommes aujourd'hui en compagnie de James Stevenson, qui est community manager à Insomniac Games. James, thank you. It's a very nice pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, very good to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
Can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, my name is James Stevenson. As you guys said, I've worked at Insomniac Games for just about a decade, and have worked on every Ratchet and Clank game since Tools of Destruction, and kind of have been leading up all the community and outreach efforts since Quest for Booty.
What do you do on this new Ratchet and Clank game?
What do I do? I mainly talk to our fans and kind of deal with the day to day, just making sure like the trailers go out and screenshots, and dealing with all of our partners in terms of working on all the kind of just materials. So coming over here to talk to people and talking to our European partners, and just dealing with everyone to make sure that they have what they need to promote the game and the movie effectively.
Okay. Yeah. So what can you tell us about this game, this new Ratchet & Clank?
Yeah, so you know, we had the movie coming, and we definitely wanted to have a game out at the same time. And so the movie is based on the original Ratchet & Clank, the 2002 PS2 video game. And we decided we were going to make a game that was kind of based on the movie, which is also based on the game. So the thing that you have to realize, though, is that game is very different from Ratchet, how Ratchet is now. You couldn't strafe, you know, the weapon arsenal was all gadgets, you didn't upgrade your weapons. So essentially, we ended up just making a brand new game that was kind of basically inspired by that first Ratchet & Clank game. So if you've played it before, you'll kind of go to some familiar locations and you'll see some familiar places, but the game plays totally differently. Just the moment-to-moment gameplay is very different. The arsenal is completely different. It's comprised of weapons from across the series and some fan favorites. The bosses, the ship gameplay, the Clank gameplay is all completely brand new. So there's tons of new stuff. And the nice thing too is, if maybe you haven't played Ratchet and Clank, this is a great game to jump in, because you know, there's, you don't need to know any of the story. You're going to start right off, and it's really got all of our latest bells and whistles from Ratchet and Clank, like all of our, you know, 15, 16 years of making Ratchet and Clank, and all that experience has gone into this one. So it's kind of a really polished and really great package.
So the gameplay is different than the original game, but is it different than Nexus, which was the last game of the Ratchet & Clank franchise?
So yeah, the last game we made was called Into the Nexus, and so the shooting gameplay and the controls are fairly similar, though we've added a few things and tightened it up a little bit. It's definitely longer than that game and has a lot more variety. One of the big things we took from that game is there's a jetpack where you could fly a jetpack around and do and kind of explore these areas, and we added some of those segments into the PS4 game. So it's those are some of my favorite parts of the game, actually.
How started the development of this game, and especially the development of the game and the movie started together?
Yeah, so it was roughly the same time when they were in full production. I think pre-production on the movie probably began a little bit earlier. We basically got started as soon as Into the Nexus wrapped up for PS3. We were basically starting working on this game, and the movie was in full production right around the same time. So we're both very busy working on you know, the movie and the game, and trying to figure out how to make those work together as best as possible. And Insomniac was super involved over the course of the film production too, just because we really wanted to make sure that it was a really good video game adaptation and a movie that our fans would be proud of.
So Ratchet & Clank franchise is 14 years old. What are the ambition of this new game?
You know, I think we see this as it's a terrific to have a film coming out, because, you know, we've always wanted to do that, and people have always compared it and always asked when a movie's going to come out. This is really a good opportunity to, you know, make something that fans are going to love, because it's, you know, it's a fun way to go back and revisit the origin story. It's a fun thing to see Ratchet and Clank on the big screen and have a movie experience. So hopefully that it's something our fans appreciate, but also it's a chance to kind of bring Ratchet and Clank to people that maybe haven't played it since the PS2, or maybe have played a game here or there, but you know, are kind of looking for another reason to try Ratchet and Clank again, or maybe they've never played Ratchet and Clank. And I think that was something where we really wanted a new entry point to the series for people as well.
What is the best experience for this new Ratchet and Clank? To watch the movie first and play the game after, or the opposite?
You know, I actually don't think it matters, and I'll tell you why. So the movie is, you know, about an hour and a half long, and if you go and see that first, which in France it comes out on the 13th and the game's not out 2 days later, so if you want them as soon as possible, you're going to see the movie first. And the movie, you know, tells the story, and you'll know some of the twists and things that happen, but there'll be a surprise for you in the movie. Then you can play the game, and the game is much longer, obviously, so at times when Ratchet and Clank might leave a planet and go somewhere else, in the movie they might arrive right away. In the game they crash land on the planet and, you know, have to deal with that and discover an info bot about some hoverboard races and decide to go check out the hoverboard races. So, you know, things like that can happen and extend it. Plus, the game is kind of wrapped by Captain Quark, so the game opens with Captain Quark in prison telling his side of the story. So you're going to get a little bit of a different version of events and Captain Quark's unique twist on things over the course of the game. So that said, so like I said, if you then played the game first, you would get Captain Quark's version, and you would see about 20 minutes of the movie is in the game, but there'd still be a whole other 70 minutes of the movie you would see when you actually saw the movie. Some of that you play instead of see, but you know, I think you would have seen Captain Quark's version of it and then go see the movie to find out what actually happened. So I think either way it works. It just depends on what your preference is and if you have time to play the game versus go see the movie or whatever.
So the game really extends the story of the movie, actually.
Yeah, the game's longer, so it actually makes the story bigger. So, you know, we definitely hit the major points of the movie for sure. But then we also have a lot more locations and planets that you're going to visit as well. And that's going to tie into some of the old locations from the original game, as well as some of the old characters from the original game, like Skid McMarks and Big Al and the Plumber. They're going to show up in different places.
You said that the game is not just a remake. But when we played it, it felt really close to the first game, but with the gameplay of the last games.
Especially the level design.
How is the game different, really?
Yeah, so I think the levels are kind of you mentioned the level design feels similar. I think some of the planets, especially some of the returning planets, Novalis, you know, when you go to Novalis, like, that has takes the layout from the PS2 game, and so it has a very similar layout and feel, but then obviously the gameplay is totally different because it plays like a modern Ratchet game. So I think the level layout is one thing that is probably still similar to the original game and one of the things that's closest in some aspects. Not every planet's like that. For instance, like Gaspar, the level layout of the original part of Gaspar is similar, like you said, and you'd recognize it. But then there's a whole new section where you can take the jetpack and fly around. So I think that's the big thing. Basically, all the Clank gameplay is completely brand new. All the ship gameplay is completely brand new. The arsenal is completely different from the first game. Weapon upgrades and Raritanium upgrades are in. The leveling up is in. The jetpack is here from Into the Nexus. I guess the other thing might be similar. The hoverboard races might actually be a little similar too. So there's a few little things that you'll find that might be kind of similar, but for the most part, the game is more new than it is even really like a remake.
Okay, so is there new weapons and new planets?
Yeah, you'll see some new planets in the game and some new locations, and there's a couple new weapons like the Proton Drum, which was in the demo you played today, and you can also get the Pixelizer, which is another new weapon, and so both of those are two of the new weapons. And then a lot of the arsenal is kind of greatest hits from the series, and most of those are from games that aren't even the first game. So when you saw the film, you saw there's a ton of weapons in the film, and you saw that greatest hits. We definitely wanted to have some carryover where weapons you saw in the film or weapons you could play with in the game. So if someone new goes and sees the movie, some of the weapons they saw in the movie they're going to be able to get is when they play the game, or the majority of them, really.
If this Ratchet & Clank is a success, would you like to develop another game?
I'll tell you, we love Ratchet & Clank, and I think we always would hope for an opportunity to be able to continue and do more, and this is a big chance for the franchise in terms of reaching new people and bringing in new fans. So this is one where we really need the fans, you know, to go see the movie, take their friends, take their family, play the game, tell their friends about the game. You know, the better this does, and that gives us more opportunity in the future. So, you know, fans really have a lot of the power because, you know, they vote by going and doing these things, buying the game and seeing the movie. And the more that happens, the bigger chances we'll have going forward to do things with Ratchet & Clank.
If if a second film is developed, would you like to adapt it as a game, or would you like to do a Ratchet that is totally different with another story, maybe the follow of Nexus? I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It would just depend. I mean, I think you know, I think we have some ideas and some things floating around, but it would kind of depend on the people that, you know, if there was going to be a sequel, what they would want to do and how that would tie in. So we're not really sure yet. We've kind of just been focused on getting this one yes. out. But, you know, I think it would be interesting, the conversations that I've had. It's kind of one of those things where we have a bunch of ideas floating around, and then if something solid starts to come together, then we'll start nailing that down. But at this point, it's just sort of a little nebulous and imagining what it could be.
After A Clock in Time, we had the feeling that Sony wasn't following Ratchet & Clank as much as they did before. Do you think that with this new game, Sony will be able to support the Ratchet & Clank series?
You know, Sony's been a great partner in developing the Ratchet & Clank series over the years, and, you know, I think the exciting thing about this game is obviously having the movie out there is a gigantic opportunity yes. for it because, you know, in the United States, for instance, we have Focus Features is releasing the film and is doing a gigantic marketing campaign around okay. it. And you're going to have the companies like here in France, the movie company is going to have a big marketing campaign with posters and things like that. And so that's really terrific because, you know, as you said, like there's, you know, games, it's always hard for games to get advertising and get awareness. And so we have a real chance to reach new players with this game and movie. And I think that's the big hope.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you for your time. It was a real pleasure.
Thank you guys for having me. And it's always great to be here in Paris in France. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.